Hello everyone, how are you doing today? Many of you have asked me this question. Why don't I create contents on very important topics like design patterns or solid principles? Well, I believe this is the time to give the answer because I am not planning to create any content on design patterns or solid principles because I am not convinced about these topics and I can't create content on the things about which I myself is not convinced about. Now, I know that my statement will raise many eyebrows and people will be thinking that what I am trying to say and what am I saying. So, hear me out till the end before making up your mind on this or before writing anything onto the comment. Okay? So, whatever I am gonna tell you over here is based on my own experience of writing codes for more than 20 years. Now, before I go ahead, let me give you a warning. Whatever I am going to tell you about these two topics are not the mainstream thoughts or mainstream beliefs regarding these things. So, if at the end of this video you agree with me, then please don't use this statement or these thoughts in your interview process or writing any exams related to computer science. Because if somebody is asking this question to you, either in an interview or in a computer science exam, they are expecting you to say that these are one of the greatest inventions which can help you to write better code and you are gonna use them, write those things, use these patterns as much as possible when you get to code. Okay, so this is the answer you must give because 99.9% of the people will be expecting this answer. Please don't give the rational what I am gonna tell you. You will hurt yourself in the interview, okay? So with this warning, I am gonna share you my experience because my experience will help you in your practical aspects of things when you are gonna write the code. Now, these two topics, design patterns or solid principles, were created with best of the intentions. Yes, that is right. And the theory also fits nicely. There is no problem with the theory, there is no problem with the intention by which these things were created. So you will ask me a question, then what is the problem? Good question. The answer is, the problem lies in the practicality of these topics and practical implementation of these topics. So there are a few points I am gonna make. First, these things were specifically created for object-oriented programming languages like C++, and Java, specially targeted for C++ programming language. And most of these things use complex inheritance mechanism provided by compilers to achieve things like, you know, virtual constructor, factory pattern and other things, okay? And if these things are really so great, why don't we see people rushing towards creating similar kind of design patterns in languages like JavaScript, Python, even Scala or other languages? People do try to do that. There are some articles on that. It didn't become the mainstream way of writing code as it was propagated for C++, for example. That's one point. The second thing is that they are very, very descriptive in nature, right? Talk about, again, factory pattern, virtual constructor. They are very, very descriptive in nature and they want me to solve my problem in a particular way. My problem is the belief that one pattern will solve all the possible problems you are looking after. Let's talk about singleton pattern. With the arrival of smart pointers, you don't need even singleton pattern, right? Because I believe singleton was one of the most widely used pattern out of all structural, creational or behavioral patterns, right? We don't need that today. And the other point is that whenever I am trying to write a code, solve a problem, people are actually suggesting me a pattern to use without even understanding what my problem is, whether my problem is good enough to be used in this particular pattern or not. They are so much descriptive, they are so much, you know, detailed without even understanding what my problem looks like. Something looks very funny to me includes this virtual constructor and factory pattern. Go back to your code and see in reality how many types of object you create. while writing your code, while solving your problem. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Believe me, it may be even less than that. And to have that, you want to create a complex hierarchy of classes to achieve what we call as virtual constructor. Why? Why this complexity is needed in my code? This is not going to make my code simple. And why should I use inheritance for that? Believe me, guys, 90% of the time people use inheritance for reusability purpose rather than making a relationship between base class and derived class. And most of the time we can live with composition, but people just blindly use inheritance because they can use these complex patterns or they can derive some complex patterns out of it. We don't need that. Now let's talk about things like solid principles, single responsibility or dependency inversion principle. Let's talk about single responsibility principle. I totally agree with it. The intention behind this principle is to keep the code clean, right? But believe me, I have seen a code where just for the purpose of single responsibility principle and one variable in the object, which is not related to other variable, a very complex set of code is created. And when I went ahead and I saw that code, I removed 50% of the code. It becomes less complex and simpler. As a programmer, I should be in charge of what is simple in the problem I am trying to solve in the complex code I am trying to write. The meaning of simplicity may be totally different for a different set of people. So let me manage my simplicity. Again, talk about dependency inversion principle. So in solid, D stands for dependency inversion. So the principle is high level modules should not be dependent on low level module. Agreed, fine. Why I need only class-based hierarchy to do that? There are other ways to do that. There are interface ways or, you know, wrapper ways to do that. Why I just need to do it in a specific way? As if the object-oriented programming itself was not complex enough with all this inheritance hierarchy with virtual functions, virtual inheritance, multiple inheritance. We are using this complex functionality to create further complex code, and we are trying to tell developers that please use those codes to keep your code simple. Somehow over a period of time, based on my experience, I reached to a conclusion that I am not gonna buy it. The other reason why I am not able to buy these things in its totality is that it has nothing to do with the functionality which I am trying to implement. You know that the functionality which I am trying to implement is extremely important because those are the things which is gonna sell our product, those are the things which is gonna give us the revenue. So those things are extremely important to me. Again, I totally agree that if everybody follow these things in its totality, maybe it can help you to write bit maintainable code. But at the end, maybe that is coming with a cost, and that cost might far outweigh the benefits which I am trying to look forward to. Okay, so guys, I have learned about all those things 10 to 15 years back, and I tried to use it again and again, and I somehow couldn't manage to convince myself. That's the reason I am not able to talk about it, not able to propagate it, because I am not convinced. Again, before I end this video, again, a specific reminder. Whatever I told you today is not for your interviews, okay? In your interviews, you have to tell what mainstream thought process is about these things. You must not tell whatever I said to you in this video, even if you agree to me. This is only and only for your practical aspect, to make things simple, to resist people unnecessarily pushing, you know, specific patterns to you. And you can say that, you know, you can apply your own brain to keep things simple. Talk with fellow programmers to understand what is the best way to keep things simple. And maybe we can learn from these things and derive something which is usable in our own context and remains simple. Okay. So as a programmer, you have the gray matter, you know better. And please use your own creativity to write a simple, maintainable and better code. That's all I had for today. Thanks a lot, people. Thanks for watching. Till the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. Take care.